Hi guys, so today another Onclick pop-up tutorial for Divi. Actually, this works on all kinds of themes because we will use a custom code. So I do have a tutorial for the Onclick pop-up for Elementor and Divi, but my other videos, the code on my other videos works on just on single pop-up only. But this theme page is different because it involves multiple modals. So if you click this one and then you click this, okay, there will be like a pop-up for the individual member. So this is the current website and we've used toggle on this. So if you click this, so she doesn't want this kind of design. So we will convert this one into multiple pop-up. So the first thing that you need is to use a code module, or if you're using an Elementor, then look for an HTML elements. Now I will put this code in here. Okay, let me just grab this one. Okay, let me grab this one. This modal content. So click the enable and we need to add 6th modal because they are, so enable the builder and then I will add a regular row and then we'll select the code module and then this one. So it has a wrapper of modal content. This will hold your pop-up and then the header that will be for header for the so I'm gonna show you the style later. So this h2, let's call that Maria Braun, and then the text. Okay, let's just put the text there. So let's go to the advanced and then we will put a unique ID for Maria. So Maria Braun, and then the class would be modal. Okay. Now after that, I'm gonna grab this information because we will no longer use this toggle design. So X. And we will put that in here. So this one. So I would put this strong. I want this to be in strong mode. Okay. And we'll put this in here. By the way, for the code, just check my... For the code, just check my article so you have more guidelines if this one is too fast. So you need to grab this code, you need to put this code and then replace your preferred content. And then after that, let's save this one. Now we will add a custom CSS to style our modal pop-up. Now go to the Divi theme options. And then I'll grab this code in here. Okay, let's copy this one and put it on the theme options. If you have child theme, then put it on your style.css. So if you convert that, and then let's try to refresh it again. So you'll notice that the pop-up is hidden because in the code, we've set the display to none. Now we will add a button listener here. So when the button is clicked, the pop-up will be visible. So I have a code here. Okay, I have a code here for the button. So this one. And let's enable the visual builder. And we'll put it after, below Maria's information. We want to have this kind of design. So instead of they don't use button in this, but let's just use button so it's more cleaner. So I'm gonna use a button. Okay, and they have, by the way, if you're not using, okay, let's just use a custom CSS for, so it is applicable on those who are not using Divi as their theme. So basically this one, and then you need to add a class. So the name for the ID is Maria Braun. That is the ID that we set on the modal earlier. And then we can put info like more. Okay, then I'll add a text there. Or more info, or if you want to use a button, and then what you can do is just use a button if you're using Divi, and then more info, and then the class name should be modal, and then okay, let me just get that. And then the ID should be linked to Maria. So that's the difference. So if you're using Divi, or if you're not using a Divi, you can use the custom HTML, or you can use the Divi. Now let's just use custom HTML to keep it general, so other user can still use this code even though they're not using Divi. So we have this already. So if you enable the exit the visual builder, okay, and then let's try to click this one. So nothing happens. Now we need to have a JavaScript to trigger this button. So we have this code in here, and then this is the code to put this on this script into the updates, integration, and then let's put it on the body section. Or if you have a child theme, create a JS file, and then let's exit and click this one. So as you can see this part, but it's already working. Now I can add Maria's pictures above her name. So I'm gonna copy that and then enable the visual builder, and then I will add an image. So let's use a wireframe because we cannot see the code because we hide it. So I will put here an image img.crc. Okay, I'm gonna remove this one. Just keep it to WP content, and then refresh. Now we already have this code. We can then duplicate the code module, and then replace it. Actually, I'm gonna rename this one to Maria's pop-up, and then this one will be for Katie's pop-up. Okay, now I will just change this information. I'm gonna grab Katie's here because we will not use the toggle. So I'm gonna remove this toggle and then put it in here. I will replace Maria's information, and then let's put this one to here. Now the only, after you make changes with the content, important thing that you need to change is the ID. Okay, so the ID, they should have a unique ID in every member. So this is for Katie, so I'm gonna call this one Katie. And actually, what is her name? Katie Pedersen. So let's put that way. So this is the ID that holds the modal. So we will duplicate this code from Maria and move it here. And then I will change the ID to Katie. Okay, and then saved and refreshed. And then let's try to exit the builder. And then let's try to click this one. More info. So you can see here, it is already Katie, business manager. I still did not change the headings, but that's really how it works right now. So this one. So if I click Maria, then this one is for Maria's information. Now we have an issue in here for the header, that PHP. What I can do, yeah. So I'm gonna change this code because it's working on the, it's covering the header. So I'm gonna change the header instead of, I'm gonna put a Z index auto. So if I refresh this one, okay. So our code is perfectly working in here. Okay, I'm gonna enable this one. So I have changes to auto. So if I and I click the more info, it just works on all pages. Now we have this issue here, so we need to keep. So that's how it works. So click the more info, and yeah. So always remember that the Z index of a pop-up should be higher in all kinds of in all elements in here. So even in the header section or in the elements and in the footer section. Actually, I haven't changed the footer yet, so I will change that later. So the final design, I'm gonna change this. I'm gonna level this hashtag later, but basically the final design looks like this. So if I click the more info, this is the pop-up, and when you click this one, it will close the pop-up. And you click more info. I haven't changed this one yet, but I'll fix this later. But yeah, but if you notice in here, it is already changing. Like the text is already changing, Katie. This one is for Daniel. I need to change the images and fix the layout of that. This is for Robin, and this is for Vaughn, and this is for Cece. But the final design is for Maria. And again, the code is in my blog, so make sure you check my website for the accurate code. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much, guys, and have a great day. I'm just